Dear students, welcome back to our channel Easy Explanation. In this tutorial we will be learning about how to print all the prime number between n1 and n2. So there will be the range of given number and we have to print all the prime number between the range. Okay, so in this tutorial we will be learning about how to check whether the given number is prime or not. Once we have the logic to check the number as a prime or not, then we can iterate the logic of prime check for the range of n1 and n2. Okay, so these are the things we will be understanding in this tutorial. So let us start the tutorial. First, we have to understand what is prime number. Prime number is any number that is divisible by 1 and itself. Suppose if I'll check whether 3 is prime or not, what I'll do is I'll start dividing 1, I'll start dividing 3, starting from 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so first divide 3 by 1. So obviously, 3 will be divided exactly divisible by 1. Now divide 3 by 2. It is not exactly divisible by 2. 3 is not exactly divisible by 2, but 3 is exactly divisible by 3. So you can see 3 is divisible by 1 and itself. So 3 is a prime number. Okay, so we'll be using this concept to write the logic for prime checking. So let's start the program. Prime underscore check dot c program to print all the prime number in given range has include tdio dot h int main. Okay, let us start write the logic to check for the given number only, not for the range, for the given number. Let us say it is a num and I'll supply the value as a 5. I'll check whether the 5 is prime or not, and we'll be using this logic to print all the number, all the prime number in the given range. So what I have to do is I will divide this number 5 by all the numbers from 2 to 4. If any of the number in the range of 2 to 4 divide 5, it means what? The given number is not prime number. Otherwise, the given number will be prime number. Okay, so we'll be using that logic. So for that, in order to divide with for the given range from 2 to 4, I need one loop. For that, I've used the I variable. So for I equals to 2, I less than num, I plus plus. Okay. Now, if the num is exactly divisible by I, okay, if num is exactly divisible by I, then break, come out of the loop. Okay, something like, let us say instead of 5 we have a number 4, so we'll be dividing this number 4 by I equals to 2 3, right? So if I'll divide I, if you divide num by 2 first, right, so 4 is exactly divisible by 2. So once this number divide, means once the value of I divides the given number num, then we'll break the loop. There is no need to check for another. So we'll conclude that this number is not prime number, right? So we'll be using this logic for that. Break. Now if the value of I is equals to num, then printf percentage d is prime. Then num else printf slash n percentage d is not prime num. Now let us check the logic. How does this thing work? If the number is 4, right? If num equals to 4, then I'll be dividing this num by all the number from 2 to 3. When the value of I equals to 2, then 4 modulus 2 is equals to 0, right? So once this condition becomes true, we have to terminate the loop by using break statement. Once we come out of the loop, the value of I will be how much? The value of I will be 2, right? And the value of num will be 4. So 2 is equals to 4. The condition is false. So this line will not be executed. Which line will be executed? Line number 15 will be executed, or else part will be executed, and it will print percentage d or 4 is not a prime number. Now let us say if the value is 5, then how does this work? So this 5 will be divided by all the number from 2 to 4. So first it will divide, 5 will divide 2, or 2 will divide 5, right? So 5 modulus 2 equals to 0, no, right? So the loop will run again. The value of I will be now 3, right? So 3 is less than num, obviously. So 5 modulus 3 equals to 0, condition become false, break will not be executed, will increment the value of I. The value of I will be now how much? 4. So 4 is less than num, true. The statement within the for loop will be executed. So the value of num is now 5. 5 modulus 4 equals to 0, false. Again, the value of I will be incremented. Now the value of I will be how much? 5, right? So 5 is less than 5, condition become false. So this loop will not be executed. The line number 12 will be executed. Now the current value of I is 5. And the num that we are checking is 5. So you can see 5 is equals to 5. The condition is true. So this thing will print what? 5 is a prime number. So in this way, you can check whether the given number is prime or not. So let us check this code, whether the logic we have written is correct or not. So for that, so GCC, I am using GCC compiler, primecheck.c. dot slash a dot out. So 5 is prime, right? So it means what? Our code is working fine. Since what is our question? Print all the prime numbers. We do not need to print the composite number or non-prime numbers. So we'll not include the else part. We'll include only the if part. Now what you have to do is we have to run all these statements, this set of statement, for the given range of values, right? So what we'll do is, so we'll create two variables first, another variable last. Okay, so first we'll hold the lowest range and last will hold the highest range. So I will ask the user printf enter the range of enter the lowest and highest range value. Okay, we'll scan f here to %d ampersand first comma ampersand last, right? Now this set of statement need to be iterated or need to be repeated for all the numbers within this range, right? So how to achieve that? So I have to run a loop. Okay, I have to run a loop. Let us say I'll be using the variable j for that. So for j equals to first j less than equals to last j plus plus. Okay, so for these range of values, what you have to do? You have to execute this set of statement, right? So enclose this thing within this loop. Now align the code appropriately for the good readability. Okay, now our code looks good. So what will be, so the first value will be assigned to variable num. So we'll do what? Num equals to first. Okay, then every time, sorry, num equals to j. So the value will be, every time the loop will iterate, the value of j will be assigned to num, and num will be checked for prime. If it is prime, it will print the, this is a prime number. So if you do not want to write something like is prime, so you can remove this statement. If you want to print it into a single line, use /t, okay, by using tab space and at last write printf /n. You can format this code again something like this, printf all the prime numbers in the range of %d and %d are I'll write print the prime number in the next range. Okay, I hope this should work. Let's check the code by executing and compiling and executing it. So it is saying, okay, all the prime numbers in the range of %d and %d, so I forget to mention the value, so it has thrown me error. So the first %d will be assigned the value of first variable, and the second %d will be assigned the value of variable last. So I hope this would work now. If there is an error, we'll try to debug it. So the best way to learn C programming is understanding the error. If you can debug the error, then you can write your logic by refining it again and again. So enter the, let us say, the first value is 1, and so our program should do what? It should print all the prime number between 1 and 100. Let us see it does or not. So 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, 47, 53, 56, 61, 67, 71, 73, 79, 83, 89, and 97. So these all are the prime number between 1 and 100. So you can say that our program has worked perfectly fine. So you can use this logic. Okay, so you can use this logic to print all the prime number in the given range. If you have any questions, any query regarding this program, then you can mention in the comment section. So I forget to write the return zero statement. It'd be better to write return zero statement at last. Okay, now the program is perfect. Thank you for listening. See you in the next tutorial.